And finally, that most of our airports are becoming notorious for extortion and bribery is no longer news. According to the Federal Airport Authority of Nigeria, FAAN, said about 6 members of the staff of various security agencies and organizations have been caught on camera extorting air travelers. Now, the federal government is talking tough about stemming the ugly trend and has threatened to sanction heads of military and paramilitary agencies at the Murtala Mohammed International Airport, Lagos, and others over extortion of air travelers. Let me start from you. I don't want to comment on this issue, but no, let me just ask Nico.
It's the same thread. What we're talking about, Omicron, is the same thing. It's just corruption. Let me give you a personal experience I had. I was going to be going to UK, so, and when I'm traveling out, I usually don't carry things. Maybe a bag, and it'll be very light, nothing, because
yeah, where you're coming.
You are not the typical Nigerian.
Yeah,
so that's at any point we like load.
So I just carry a bag. Of course, it went through the equipment that checks, and the thing went out, and there was nothing. The guys gave me my bag, and I went through, and as I was walking into, you know, the final room where before you enter into the chute that takes you to
the aircraft. Very hot place.
That, you know, it's very cold.
No.
The ice, the air, I was shivering.
Okay.
Yes. Mm. So I was the first person anyway, but eventually we became, you know. So I saw a woman sleeping. You know, suddenly she said, "What are you doing? Where are you going?" Ah. But I mean, I wouldn't be going like that if I don't have reasons to be. So she harassed me. And then she said, "Let me see your bag." So I opened my bag. I gave it to her. I put everything on the table so that she can see that there's nothing. She looked at it. I said, "You can put it back." I put it back. They can now say, "What do you have for
just
us?"
Just hold your breath there. Let's take this breather. When we come back, we'll talk more. It's still Journalist Hangout. Stay with us. Thank you for staying with us, and before we went on break, Lekan Shatter.
Yeah.
You're narrating your experience.
Yeah. So she then asked, after I packed my bag and I was going, she said, "What do you have for me?" I said, "I didn't know that I would meet you here." But what I really want to point out is that our security. Yes, it's a woman.
No, it's you that I'm referring to. You're a wicked man.
What I'm saying is,
you didn't factor her into
it. I didn't think she was, I was going to meet her. So our security system generally. I'll tell you another experience. As you are going, driving from Penn Cinema to Agege, that Agumbiadin Street, again, over the railway line, you know, when the railway is coming, it will stop you. So we stopped. I saw a yellow fever talking to somebody on the phone. Say, come and join us. No do. At the end of every day, you will go home with some 2,000-3,000 naira. Come and join. This is a very lucrative business, so come and join. He was saying that tells you that people marketing. Even join security institutions in Nigeria to not because they want to do the job.
Money.
Thank you.
Wow.
Because it has always been like that. When you get to, you know, foreign airport and they smile, they get your passport, get everything, they deal with you professionally and ask questions and you go. Sometimes if they are
happy to do
the job. They are happy to do the job. But once you get into that Murtala Mohammed International Airport, one thing that even change that atmosphere. If you go to
Togo,
Togo Airport, Togo, they have a new airport, Togo. If you go to Kotoka in Ghana, you know, the ambience and everything. But these are Murtala Mohammed International Airport. Once you get there like this, hostile looking, frustrated people just sit down. All their aim and objective,
you know,
is to make sure they frustrate you, and they want to extort you.
You won't even see Morocco, Rabat, you won't see any security person. You won't see anybody.
Okay, in Casablanca.
Yes, you won't see. You won't see.
That's anybody. Very close to Europe.
I'm not even saying that's Africa now.
No, it's Africa. We just have to clean up our nasty behavior. People, and you know, we do this not just to Nigerians. We do it to foreigners,
especially foreigners.
We do not discriminate.
We expect
no
that
matter
they will
the
have
of your skin.
Yes.
You see a white man, you assume that this man is smelling dollars.
Mm.
So you want to extort money from him. We are now, I think there was a video that went viral that has pushed the authorities now to decide to descend heavily on these people. This thing will stop when we allow the heads of the buses to roll. Because the buses at the airport, another entry points into our country, they are the ones who post people to those places. Yeah. Mm. Now, when you continue to make heads of the big people, your guys at the top, you allow their heads to roll. Yes. When you receive this kind of report, it will percolate down to the most junior of all that this thing will not be tolerated. People, no matter what, no matter how poorly you are paid, you are supposed to remain on the job because you are happy to do the job. Mm. People can't, on account of earnings, what is not enough by their own estimation, then turn themselves to glorified beggars.
And if you know what they do to get these airport postings, because that's all the juicy agencies to get, especially MMA.
You see, the thing, there is nowhere, you see, all over the world, there are professions that will not give you so much. You understand?
Mm.
Uh-huh. So, you that you have come into that profession, you come into the profession because you believe that, look, this is a good job for you. You can't come and be complaining to people that, you are not getting paid good salary, therefore you need to assist me, you need to give me this. No. It's just terrible. And somehow, Nigerians, foreigners have come to the conclusion that one negative thing that signposts our airports is this idea of begging by immigration officials. They've given Nigeria a bad name. Hmm. It looks like it's late in the day.
Yes.
It looks like it's late in the day now that we are fighting this scourge. But it is not too late.
And it's the first contact you have with the country.
Yes.
The impression that creates a long-lasting impression.
Once you come into our country and they say, your people are here. Your boys are here.
Yes.
Your boys are here. Once we hear that, you know that they are telling you to give them something. And look, because this is a program that is watched all over the world.
They're watching us.
It's not everything that we can say, because we also not want to embarrass our country. But we demand that those in authority
should stop.
Descend heavily on this negative behavior of people at the entry point into our country, because it's giving us such a bad name. It has to stop, or even reduced to the barest minimum. There was a white woman that shot a video, some years back.
Yes.
I think about 3 or 4 years ago, I saw that video talking about this extortion at the airport. So this is something that we've got to a problem that we have to deal with.
From custom, immigration, fan staff, fan security, quarantine, everybody that's, you know, you have working at that international airports to get involved. I think we have a caller. Thank you for staying with us.
Good evening.
Good evening, please.
Yeah,
good evening. Good evening.
Thank you.
Good evening, sir.
But what the consequent management? This consequent management, if anything that happens, somebody is responsible for it. The current leader we have, that knowledge of consequent management, they don't have the political way to deal with the swimmer, which boils down to the fact that they also involved in the corruption we are talking about. For crying out loud, airport is a legacy between Nigeria and most of these foreign countries. And the way you behave will dictate to people the kind of government you have in mind. I see no reason why anybody that is doing it doesn't have gotten his paper correct from the thinking about the day. If you travel to abroad, if you travel to London, they have their state and let them reach our population, which you must follow.
I think we get the gift of what you're saying. So that we should follow everything to the letter, not that you'd have, you know, at a point in time, they will ask you if you've converted your money to the foreign currency, because you don't have naira on you, and you say you don't have naira on you, what you have is dollar. I say, bring it, okay? They say that's better. that's better.
Who does not know that? No, they want the green back.
No, they want it. So it's very, very important. Look, now I think it should not be at the airport alone. If you go to any civil service office and everything, you go to anywhere, it's still the same thing we still do. I think it's something that we need to not change.
Let me even also add.
We have to go.
Even the police, you go. No. When they are going.
That one we can do a whole program on that. We can do a whole program. I think why this one is so shameful is that is the entry point.
Points, and that's the first impression.
Yes. It's not good. It's not good for our image.
Liko Shote, thank you so much for your contribution.